Well, Amy Eveleth from the Maryland Zoo in Baltimore joins us with a couple of interesting, we hope not pets.
Yes, we don't want these as a pet, and I brought slow guys because I can keep up with them right now. So that's why I brought the turtles. So we have an eastern box turtle here. This is Raphael, one of our Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
I found guys like him in my mulch pile.
Yeah, good. I'm glad you found some because they're hard to find in Baltimore right now. In Maryland, they're having a lot of trouble. They live in wooded areas, and a lot of that has been destroyed to make housing, so and highways and whatnot. So what happens is the turtles get displaced. They really don't have anywhere to go. They have very specific home ranges, especially the eastern box turtles. So they live in this like 3-mile area where they find all of their food and they spend their entire lives. So if you pick them up and transplant them, they really do have trouble finding resources on their own.
They get
disoriented. So they're you know, pretty cool turtles. People like to grab them up and keep them as pets, but I definitely don't recommend it. They have very strange diets. Their diets change from when they're very, very small to when they're larger, whereas they eat a lot of meat when they're little and not so much when they're adults. Lettuce will kill them. It will dehydrate them, so it's not something you want to give them. So if you want to, you know, take a look at them from afar, that's the best way to do it. You can see them at the Maryland Zoo. We do have a turtle exhibit in the Maryland Wilderness.
And these are turtles, not tortoises, right?
They are turtles. That's right. This is an eastern box turtle. It's the only turtle that can completely enclose itself in its shell, which is pretty cool. Mm-hmm. A lot of people think all turtles can do that, but they can't. This turtle has a creased carapace down here, which is the bottom part of the shell, which is attached to their body. His spine is in the back of it, and he can enclose his entire body right up in there and suck it all up.
Completely protected.
Exactly. Yeah. Unlike this little bog turtle here who can't do that, what he does is he pulls his head in and his tail, and then he uses his legs to protect his face.
Oh, I see. They kind of go in front
of them. Exactly. They take the defensive pose. But this is a critically endangered animal, this little Wade the bog turtle right here. They do live in Maryland. Mm-hmm. They live in wetlands. You can find them in New Jersey, Pennsylvania. Very, very limited
The box turtle will be in drier environments.
In a drier environment. That's right. This is a marshland, fresh spring water.
Are these sizes relative to what you would find in?
They are. This is a full-grown female box turtle. Mm-hmm. You can tell if it's a male, it has like a dent in its shell on the bottom. Mm-hmm. This is not a full-grown bog turtle, but the bog turtle does get to be about 4 inches long, so he will get a little bit bigger. Mm-hmm. They're hard to find. They're hard to see. It's very rare that you would see them out in the wild, but they are one of the most critically endangered species in the country.
And you can see them at the zoo.
That's right. You can see them at the Maryland Zoo.
And what else
zoo.
Can we see there?
You can see a baby pygmy goat, super, super
brand
cute.
Brand new, right?
Brand new. She's not even a week old. She was born last Sunday. Her name is Lana.
Well, they already have a name for it.
They do. Yeah. The keepers, they are right on that. Look at her. Smush. I just love her. She's so cute.
Wow.
So you can see her right in the farmyard. Come on down to the zoo. Admission, I believe, is $16.50 if you come on down on the weekends, $14.50 during the week. Huh. Or you can buy a membership for $100. It's you and an adult that live in the household and any of the kids that live in the household as well. So.
How big is she?
She's just a couple of pounds. She is tight, like small dog size.
Like a foot?
Not even a foot yet. Yeah. So she's about pug size right now. Little, not as fat, but about that tall. So you can see her.
Wow.
We do want to tell people that the tundra buggy is going to be closed for a little bit longer, but Polar Bear Watch is opened back up today.
All right. So something goes closed, but something's opening.
Something's opening. That's right.
Amy, thanks for joining us along with our turtles.
That's right.
Keep on the lookout for them.